Hello, I am Jan Leilings and I will talk about our BiShard framework for providing sharding in a Byzantine environment. This is joint work with Mohamed Sadoghi. Recently, we have seen a surge in resilient systems that can deal with Byzantine failures. Unfortunately, these systems are typically fully replicated, which puts severe restrictions on their performance. To improve on this, one can consider adding scalability via sharding. We can, for example, break up all the data in our system into an African, an American, an Asian, and a European shard. By doing so, the African shard can process African requests, while at the same time the American shard can process American requests. Sharding does introduce complexity, however, as we need to coordinate between the shards to process multi-shard requests that affect data in several shards. For example, a request that transfers data from the African shard to the American shard. Typical systems process a multi-shard transaction using two techniques. First, we need a replication method to replicate the transaction among all involved shards. For this, we can use two-phase commit. Second, we need a concurrency control method to assure a consistent execution of transactions that are processed in parallel by several shards. For this, we can use two-phase locking. To build these methods, we only need local computations at the shards and communication between the shards. If we make shards fault tolerant, then each shard is a cluster of replicas of which some can be faulty. In such an environment, every local computation within a shard needs to be done via consensus. This to assure that all replicas in that shard maintain the same state. At the same time, communication between shards can be done with a cluster sending primitive that can deal with any faulty replicas. Unfortunately, consensus in such a system is notoriously expensive, and even the best implementations are only able to do a few thousand decisions per second. Hence, we want to minimize the use of consensus. In BiShard, we minimize the use of consensus during multi-shard transaction processing by merging replication and concurrency control steps. To do so, we propose the orchestrate execute model. In this model, transaction processing is broken down into individual shard steps that are each performed by a single shard via a single consensus step. And we use cluster sending to forward transaction processing between shards. We use three types of shard steps, namely vote steps that are used by shards to determine whether they can commit and execute transactions, commit steps that execute the transactions, and abort steps that clean up transactions that cannot be executed. In this model, the execution method determines the local operations of a shard step, for example, obtaining logs, checking conditions on data, or releasing logs. The orchestration method determines how controls transferred between shard steps, for example, in which order individual shards vote whether they can commit, and how a final commit decision is made. To illustrate the orchestrate execute model, we look at a simple example. Consider the transaction that transfers $500 from Anna at shard A to Bo at shard B if both Anna and Bo have sufficient funds. The first shard step is a vote step at shard A. This vote step locks Anna's account, checks whether Anna has sufficient funds, and if this holds, the step instructs shard B to execute the second shard step. Otherwise, the transaction can be aborted and we simply release the lock on Anna. The second shard step is a vote step at shard B. This vote step locks Bo's account and checks whether Bo has sufficient funds. If Bo has sufficient funds, then the transaction can be committed and executed. To do so, $400 is added to the account of Bo and shard A is instructed to commit via the third shard step. If Bo does not have sufficient funds, then the transaction is aborted and shard A is instructed to also abort via the fourth shard step. Finally, either the third or the fourth shard step is performed by shard A to commit or abort the transaction. The orchestration methods in Bichart resemble standard two-phase commit protocols, except that the orchestration does not have to deal with failures, as consensus and cluster signing already take care of that. In Bichart, we provide three methods of orchestration that each make their own performance trade-offs. First, in a linear orchestration, all vote steps are done in sequence. That allows this method to abort the entire transaction immediately after a single abort vote. Unfortunately, the linear orchestration method will do a lot of steps in sequence when transactions affect many shards. To improve on that, we provide centralized orchestration. In centralized orchestration, a single root shard instructs all shards to perform their votes in parallel, after which the root shard decides whether to commit the transaction. To assure that the root shard can process these votes efficiently, we show in the paper that the root shard can do so with only a single consensus step. Finally, we provide distributed orchestration, in which all shards receive all votes and can independently decide whether to commit the transaction. In doing so, we can eliminate one sequential phase from centralized orchestration at the cost of an increase in communication. The main task of the execution methods is to provide a consistent execution of the transactions, for example by enforcing serializable execution. Due to the uses of consensus, all shard steps are already executed in a strict sequential order on each shard. Hence, even without further concurrency control, Bichart will already provide write uncommitted execution. Higher isolation levels can be provided via two-phase locking. In specific, to provide serializable execution, we first have to lock all the data items that are used by the transaction. If a lock is already in use, the transaction waits until the lock becomes available again, and after obtaining all locks, the transaction can be executed, after which all locks are released. To assure a minimal cost, we show in the paper that obtaining locks can be done without additional consensus steps, this even when transactions have to wait for in-use locks. The uses of locks can cause deadlocks. To prevent this, we either use blocking locks with a strict order in which locks are obtained, or we use non-blocking locks that abort the transaction if they are already in use. Finally, we also provide read uncommitted execution and read committed execution by providing different strategies to obtain write locks and read locks. We can combine the orchestration and execution methods of bicharts, this to obtain 18 different multi-chart transaction processing protocols. Furthermore, also protocols such as AHL and ChainSpace can be expressed within the orchestrate execute model. To evaluate the strengths of each multi-shard transaction processing protocol, we have performed an in-depth performance evaluation. But for brevity, we had to omit some of these results in this presentation. In these graphs, we have plotted the results of this evaluation. In specific, we have the total runtime for a workload of 5,000 transactions and the committed throughput of this workload, both as a function of the numbers of shards that each hold the same amount of data. As one can see, the isolation-free methods clearly have the lowest runtime and the highest throughput. This is especially the case when not using linear orchestration. At the same time, the serializable lock-based methods still show good performance and good scalability as a function of the number of shards. Furthermore, the very low runtime of the centralized and decentralized non-blocking lock-based methods guarantee high committed throughput even in the presence of a higher abort rate due to lock contention. Hence, even when requiring expensive concurrency control, one can still provide scalable sharding in a Byzantine environment. To conclude, we have proposed Bichart as a general-purpose framework for shard resilient systems. As part of this framework, we have proposed 18 high-performance multi-shard transaction processing protocols. These protocols can be used together within a single system, thereby providing fine-grained transaction-level control over throughput, isolation-level latency, and abort rates.